All right, we're back against Lee Blank. Let's do this. Against Lee Blank, I usually change my runes a little bit. I started with a little bit magic resist. Because she has that crazy burst all the time, kind of helps me a little bit. Just can't let her poke me like that. Pretty rusty today. I said I'm pretty comfortable against Lee Blank, but we'll see. She used Ignite. It's funny how Lee Blank needs a gank with the Charmer. It gets tricky when you're against Lee Blank and she gets help from the Charmer. Then you're in real trouble. Should actually go back, but. Yep, I should have gone back. Only against Lee Blank I buy a few more potions. This is probably the last one. The one thing, if you're against Lee Blank, you can pretty much forget about the help from the jungler, because it's people usually don't gank this guy. She's hard to gank. She's gonna have a level 6 first. Just eat my own words. Only when she's low, you can expect a gank. This guy again. And again. What are these guys' pre-mates? Best friends? I mean, if you're really having a trouble against Lee Blank, instead of buying boots, maybe buy a little bit of magic resist. She plays pretty aggressively, so. A couple of pokes. I feel pretty much. Much better. Mm-hmm. might go top pretty soon. Just have to keep an eye on. Aimer is fell wet. Fade. Well, they don't have too many tanks, so. See, I just have to play defensively, get my items. Maybe they will make mistakes and. Lee is back. Back to save the world again. This aiming is never gonna get better. Some days it's bad, and some days it's really, really bad. Kill for kill. Didn't have my stun up. Ultimate up, but I'm going back. Catelyn was pretty low, but I would have to hit all three shots, and it's not gonna happen today. By the looks of it, this tower has surprisingly high health. It's about time you die. Messing up with the Q. I don't really know what tips I can give you guys against Leeblank. It's hard to play against, but don't let her attack you. You have the range advantage. You have to use it. I never go in with the Q or stun rather. Because if you miss that stun, it's pretty much dead. Oh, look who's here. World Sail. Just bought my... bought my ultimate. What I always try to do is just try to make them guessing. Fake moments. Against Li Blank, I usually only poke with Q. Only try to use stun when she comes in. See, she can't take too many of those pokes. If you hit few Qs, then you can just pop the ultimate, and even now I could pop the ultimate. Missing so bad, it's ridiculous. I'm out of here. Shut down. I'm just playing defensively now and waiting for them to make mistakes, countering on them. Like so. Kill by kill. Soon I have enough damage to carry this whole team if I have to. I am missing my ultimate, but I'm not missing Qs too much. Trying to save that stun for Li if he comes in. This Bobby is hard to kill. Right now I'm trying to get the minions done. I'm out of mana. Not good. Get those minions down. Going back. Wait. Yeah. think I get this tower. Now this will suck if we don't get this Baron. Go back, get more damage. Now it feels like a winnable game. Sometimes you just have to slowly pick him apart. Even Bob is taking pretty good damage on the white stuff. I mean, at this point it's pretty much even with Lee Blank. Kill her as fast as she can kill me. I'm not gonna use the stun on Bobby because it's pretty pointless. Better to save it for the Lee Sin or somebody else. I don't know, we have power on, we should keep pushing. Okay, now I might use the stun for a bit. Yet. Maybe get this guy too. Oh yeah, they gave up.